Hey guys, welcome to Laratips. In today's video, we'll be looking at three new things that are added to Laravel version 9.4.1. We'll be looking at one thing that is added to Laravel version 9.3.1 and two from the Laravel version 9.4. So let's get started. The first thing that has been added is this whereNot method to the query builder and Eloquent builder. So here, let me show you, we can do it like this. Let's say, so we have some users here in the database, and I want all those users whose name is not this or email is not this, then we can do it like this. So first of all, let me show you what will be the SQL query for this. It will add not in front of this thing. So where not and this thing. So before we had this where like this, and you can see here it is added this anything that is inside this function or a closure inside this round brackets, which means everything that is inside this will be evaluated first and then it will check not in that. So before we had this where, and instead of where not, we only would get where, but now we also have this where not, so we'll get where not as well. So this is a very good addition. So here we'll get all the users that don't have name this and email this. So this is same as doing this. So where, and here we'll do not equal to, and instead of here we'll do like this, and here we'll say not equal to. And if we just do it like this, then this will give us the same results. The query is different, but we'll get the same results. If I just do here get like this and hit run, and you can see here I am not getting the users with the ID 1 and 2 because these users are these two, this name and this email, okay? But now let me just go just undo the changes and just hit get. And you can see here the result is same. Now let us look at the second thing that has been added. And also I'll leave the link of this whereNot documentation of this website just below that like button. You can just have a look at this. So the second thing that has been added is the soleValue method to the query builders. So before we had this sole and value separate methods on the query builder. So I'll show you this. So here the user name is this lane, and this is the name, and the ID of this user is 1. So if we only wanted ID from that user, then we can just use value. Suppose let's say this user did not exist in our database, then it will return null. So I'll just do this, then it will return null. But if we try to access it like this, first and then ID, like this, then it will throw an error. You can see here we are getting a warning. But in this case, we'll not get warning or error, but we'll just get the value as null. I'll just make it as before and hit run, then we'll get 1. If we only want to get 1 value, then we can do it like this. But we also have this sole method over here. It will check if there is only 1 value in the database. If it has more than 1 value, then it will just throw an exception. So I'll run this. I am getting this user model since there is only 1 user with this name. I'll show you this here. There is only 1 user. So it is giving me this user, and I also have another user. There are 2 users with the same name. So if I just run this, then it will give me this error, multiple records found exception, 2 records were found because this lane, we have this 2 records over here. Because of this, it is giving us error. So we can make sure that only 1 record is available in our database by using this sole method. But now there is one soleValue. This is the new method that has been added. So suppose let's say we wanted the value of a record and make sure that it is only present once. Then we didn't have anything before. We had to do some if conditions and check. But now there is this soleValue method which we can use to make sure that we are only getting the value of a single record from the database. So if I just hit run, then I'll again get the same error because this lane we have 2 records, but this one we only have 1 record. Let me just write here ID and hit run, then I'll get 2 because this Henrik Legros, he has the ID of 2. So this is the new method that has been added. Now the third thing that has been added is this lcfirst method on the str helper and also the stringable class. And I'd also tell you the benefit of that lcfirst class as compared to the default php class. So this lcfirst, Apple will lowercase the first letter. You can see here the first letter is lowercase. But here, if we just apply lcfirst on this one, which is not an ASCII character. So this is a non-ASCII character, this again. And if we reload, then it is not able to lowercase that. And the one that has been implemented over here, if we just run here, it is lowercasing the apple, and it can even lowercase this non-ASCII character.